How to program and operate the iMini data logger. This is the temperature and humidity monitoring data logger which can be operated with just start and stop buttons. This device has large LCD display to show the current temperature, maximum and minimum temperature achieved while recording and the reading durations. The data logger can be programmed with high and low alert levels by which the device will indicate the alarm with the colored LEDs when the measured value exceeds the limit. The recorded data can be downloaded in PDF, CSV and TXT format. The device has great features. It has large LCD display with easy to read functions. The device has bookmarking and continuous recording option. There are models with various memory capacity. It has four alarm indicators. High, 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 low, low, low. You can only use the device after it is programmed. Make sure to press the start button only if it is in ready mode. To program the device, you have to first connect it to your PC via USB. Now open the console plus software. When the data logger is connected to the PC, it will automatically appear on the screen. You can see the general details of the device such as serial number, product number, memory capacity, etc. Here you can also change the description. Below here you can set four level of temperature threshold levels. You can activate or deactivate the alarm. Set the values of alarm, etc. Like the same, by clicking on this tab you can set the alert levels for humidity. You can set high-low level alerts. And this tab is used for external sensor if connected. This is the sampling interval. You can change the sampling interval in seconds, minutes or hours. As you change the sampling interval, the total recording duration also changes. Now when I change the sampling interval, you can see the total recording also changes. The total recording changes every time when you change the sampling interval. Make sure to press the max button. If you want to start manually using the start button, disable the start at button and press this button to program the data logger. The device is now programmed and is ready for recording. Now hold the device and press the start button to start the recording. You can see three lines on the screen, which means that the recording has been started. The device will monitor the current temperature and humidity. If you want to stop the recording, press the stop button. The device will show stop on the screen, which means that the recording has been stopped. If you want the data logger to start and stop at a particular time, you can set the start time and the stop time. If in case you are keeping the data logger in a delivery van, you can choose this option. The data logger will automatically start and stop. Press this button to program. The device will start recording at a defined time. You can see that the data logger started automatically. It will also stop as per the defined stop time. If you want only auto start and does not want auto stop, you can program accordingly. If you want the device to start after few days, hours or minutes, you can set the delay time and the device will start after the specified delay time. Press this button to program. You have to press start button on the device, and the device will start recording at a defined time. You can see the device starts automatically after the delay time. Why wait time is required? Suppose you want to start the data logger in room temperature and keep it inside the cool box. It is better to have a delay time of 10 minutes. In this case, the room temperature will not be recorded, and within 10 minutes, the data logger will stabilize inside the box. If you want to program many data loggers in the same manner, you can program the devices with a template, so you don't need to enter the values again and again. For this step, you have to open the console plus software and connect the device. and enter all the programming parameters as explained earlier. And now to save the template, hover over to the File menu, and click Save Template. Select a folder where you want to save the template. Now press this button to program the data logger. The data logger is now programmed. Now we will connect another data logger. To load the same template, hover over to the File menu again, and choose Load Template. Open the saved template. You can see the settings are similar to the one that we saved earlier. Now press this button to program. The device is programmed. Hereafter, the template remains on the screen. You simply have to insert new logger and press Program button. That's it. This way you can program many data loggers. Over the next few hours we are going to record the device for the demo. After few hours of recording, the device now shows the high and low level alerts. You can see that both lower level alarm and the higher alarms were activated. By pressing the start button once again, the device will show you various high and low alert readings. The device also shows you the duration for which high and low levels were crossed. Now connect the device to the computer. You can see that the data automatically downloads when connected. Now the graph screen appears indicating the entire duration of recording. This is the histogram which is showing number of recording versus temperature and humidity. This is table which displays entire recording. You can see the date, time, temperature and humidity readings. You can also see the high and low reading in different color pattern. This is the summary screen which will display various programming parameters and summary of readings including high and low levels. To download the data, check out our other video on how to download the data from iMini Data Logger. VackerGlobal supplies all types of data loggers for industrial and commercial applications.